That's right, Randy. Yeah, it's looking right now like that system's going to track a little bit more toward the west. We'll get all into it right now. But first, we do have another storm out there, Tropical Storm Erin, still way out there in the Atlantic. As you can see, not looking that impressive either, but it is still a tropical storm right now. Max sustained winds of 40 miles per hour, moving to the west northwest at about 16 miles per hour. And notice the pressure hasn't changed a whole bunch right now. It's at 10.07. Now, as we put this in motion, notice what happens. Winds do increase to about 45 miles per hour. This is going to be overnight Saturday into Sunday. And then as it continues across the Atlantic, it's going to diminish and become nothing more than a remnant low. This could really dissipate before then. All here, there is some dry air. Also, sea surface temperatures not that great for tropical cyclone development or to continue that tropical cyclone. Now, 50% chance across the Yucatan right now. 50% chance, that's a medium chance, says the National Hurricane Center. But if we look at this and scrutinize it just a little bit more, let me show you right over here. See that purple right there? That is a high cold cloud top. That's intense thunderstorm activity. This is a bit of energy that has broken off from this circulation. Now, the models, the initial models are initializing right here. They're saying the center of circulation is in this general direction, but I don't see much, do you? And you can see we have relatively clear skies there. What I think has happened in the overnight hours, some dry air has moved in. All of this, that's dry air. And we are getting hints right here at the end of this loop, right about there, some hints of some upper-level shear. So my thinking right now is this has become less organized, although, like I said, the National Hurricane Center does keep it with a 50% chance or a medium chance of becoming a tropical system. A little word on steering, we're watching this upper-level trough, and I think this trough is going to play a factor. The strength of this trough is going to dictate how much moisture we get, but it is going to serve to help draw that moisture from this system, which right now looks like it's going to track toward the west. Here's our in-house RPM model. Notice by 12:30 on Saturday afternoon, here's some of that moisture being drawn up. Note the counterclockwise spin will help pull that up also in the upper levels. Keep in mind of that trough. And then as we move ahead in time, this is going to be 4:30 a.m. on Sunday. This, our in-house RPM model, tries to create a closed center of circulation, but notice where it's going. It's heading toward Texas, just south of Houston, and for us, maybe a little bit of rainfall by the time we get to Monday. That's the latest in our in-house RPM. Take-home messages, still a lot of uncertainty. We are going to monitor, but right now, looks like it's going to be somewhat of a rain event, if at all, as we hit, Sunday and a Monday. Right now, we've got some rainfall along the coast, though. Take a look. You saw that. We'll back it up just one more time. There it is. So this rain across Plaquemines Parish, it should stay there during the morning and the afternoon. We are going to be working in just a slight rain chance. Temperatures on the North Shore and across the Mississippi Gulf Coast, lower 70s. And pretty much the same situation south of Lake Pontchartrain, although we do get to the 77, mid-70s to upper 70s around the airport. And Kenner, 81 at the lakefront. So a little bit warmer as you get south shore of Lake Pontchartrain. Winds kind of out of the north, out of south, a little variable right now. Again, here's some of that shower and thunderstorm activity with only a little bit of cloud cover overhead. As we take a look at the forecast model, 20% chance of rain for today. Today going to be kind of a carbon copy of what we saw yesterday. Now, things get interesting as we get into tomorrow. I'm going to leave a 30% chance of rain. Not buying this yet because the placement of that trough will dictate if this starts moving over us or if it starts moving more toward the east. So we'll keep that 30% chance of rain with the idea that rain chances could be going up as we get into Saturday and Sunday. We're going to be heading out to the Saints game. Looks pretty good, partly cloudy, just a slight rain chance as you start your tailgating and even as you exit the dome. Highs today, they're going to be running in the upper 80s to lower 90s, and there's a 30% chance of rain for Saturday and Sunday. As you look at weather, we're going to turn now and get a check of those roadways with Susan Isaac.
Thanks, Jay, and still, so far so good. If you are out in the east, as promised, that's where we're going right now. I-10 at Chef. If you're headed inbound, lovely. Outbound, even better. Not much happening if you're going out towards Slidell. Slidell, twin span commuters, no problems at all crossing the lake. No advisors or restrictions there or on the causeway. Meanwhile, clocking 57 miles per hour at the high rise, 6 minutes from Chef to the CBD. Taking it out west, if you are traveling on the 610, 60 miles per hour there, 50 on the I-10, 26 on Airline, and 60 on the Pontchartrain Expressway as you make your way into the CBD.